The Lord has created this beautiful world. But we are conscious of the fact that when the Lord wanted to create this beautiful world, the fallen angels who are thrown away from the heavenly abode, which we read in Ezekiel chapter 28 and Isaiah chapter 14, those evil elements were already hovering. They have made the earth shapeless and filled with darkness. This is the state of life in which we too live. The world in which we live may look like a shapeless world, maybe a world without any order. You don't know where to go, full of darkness, full of disturbances. But then the Lord, mighty God, who sent the Holy Spirit, who sent the word of God to transform this beautiful world, is with us. Our God, as we read in Romans chapter 8 verse 28, for those who love him, our God turns everything into good. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yesterday your story may be that you are being despised by the world. Hannah was a woman who did not have a child. Because she did not bring forth her body, the world thought her body is useless. The husband thought, through her I can't have a children. So he went and married another lady. But not Hannah. Hannah knew, it doesn't matter what kind of body I have, what kind of world I have, what kind of evil spirits are attacking my family, I know where to go. She went to the temple of the Lord. She spoke to the Lord and she got a son, a great prophet Samuel. And she was generous to offer even that one son for the Lord. Who can stop that lady? For her to live in a glorious life, she lived a glorious life. The husband despised her. The wife whom the woman, the husband married with her children, they made fun of Hannah. But Hannah knew her power. Hannah knew the Lord. Hannah knew the word of God. Hannah knew the temple of the Lord. She cried and God gave her. That's why she gives her witness in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 8 onwards. My God raises the poor from the dust and he lifts the beggar from the ash heap to set them among the princes and make them inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are the Lord's, and he has set the world upon them. He will guard the feet of his saints. The wicked, he will silence them and destroy them. Yes, same thing our mother, blessed Mother Mary, spoke in Luke's Gospel chapter 1. The Lord has looked upon the lowly one, and he has raised me. Holy is his name. Yes. We have a God who, all those who love him, all those who believe in him, he raises them up. The enemy comes, as Jesus said in John's Gospel chapter 14 verse 30. The ruler of the world is always running behind me. 24 hours without sleep he is running behind me. Through me he wants to shame the Lord. But he will be shamed. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. We read in the book of Genesis, God created man, Adam and Eve, with great love. He breathed his breath into them. He made them in his image and goodness. With one bone, he made a beautiful woman. But knowingly or unknowingly, they fell in sin. They lost the glory. The moment fell in sin means you move away from the presence of God. And when you fall in sin, you realize that you have to save yourself. You have to build up yourself. You have to protect yourselves. And they plucked out few leaves to tie around themselves. This is the sin and consequence of sin. Sin makes you to move away from God. And sin makes you to protect yourself. You cannot protect yourself. But the Lord comes down to be with them. If you are not with Him, He will come to be with you. That is our God. Praise the Lord. And He saw His children are struggling with the both the leaves, trying to catch the leaves to protect them. He says, keep quiet. I have higher things for you. He killed an animal, shed the blood for His children, and brought the skin. I'm sure till the end of their journey on this earth, they were using it. The leaves are flown away within a day. You and I try to protect ourselves. We hold on to that which is passing away. He comes and gives us that which is eternal, lifelong, life-giving. That's why we read in 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 18. Don't throw away that which is eternal and life-giving, which God gives to you at the cost of that which you see in the world. The pleasures that you get in the body are because of the temptations the enemy brings into your life. Don't get upset. Don't allow yourself to get into sadness. No! That's why in the book of Romans chapter 5 we read, through one man sin came into the world, it's true. But God never left that man. God so loved the world that He sent His only Son for you and me. Yes. That none of us should perish but have life. And that Son gave everything of Himself. He was wounded for our sake, to heal our wounds. He carried the crown of thorns for us, that all the curses which we have earned in our life will be moved away. Knowingly, unknowingly, you have aborted the children. You carry the curses. But the merciful God, when you go to Him and cry to Him, He removes the curses. Knowingly, unknowingly, you go to and worship all kinds of unwanted elements. Go to wrong places. Wrong persons try to use you, abuse you, and the evil enters through man. One man told me, Father, whole night I saw first time in my life the evil spirit surrounding me and tying me, trying to kill me. I said, where did you go? He said, I went to a prostitute. When he went to the prostitute, all the evil spirit in her came into him. Then I told him, do not lose courage. Look at the cross. On that cross, He has carried away your curses. Look unto Him and be radiant. Your face need not be filled with shame. You have done the mistake. Repent for it. And make a commitment. You will not do it anymore. Go to Him. He is the source of life. He repented. As he was repenting itself, the evil spirit in him was speaking to him, I will not leave you. But he began to speak the word of God, that I live by the one who has loved me. No one can separate me from the love of Christ. No one can separate me from the love of Christ. When he was speaking the word again and again, the evil spirit left him. He just fell down. Almost 2 hours he slept. He got up and said, "The sleep that left me has returned back. The peace that has gone away returned back to me." The evil spirit run away from you by the one who has loved us. Mm-hmm. Yes. Through one man, sin has come into the world. But you and I have a savior. Through that man, we have got back the life and salvation. My dear friends, Sangamam Plus TV is God's gift for you for our times. Like, comment, share and subscribe. God will do wonders in your life. Praise the Lord.